I'm here with Tom Goode. Couldn't make a trip to Heath Farm without a chat with Tom. Tom, lovely to see you on that beautiful, beautiful chestnut mare. I think we just all fingers crossed that Verdon will be able to go ahead.
Yeah.
Just tell us a little bit about her from your perspective. Why riding her just excites you so much?
She just gives me a really good feeling. When I tried her at Andreas's, I instantly had a good connection with her. She reminded me a lot of a horse I used to ride called Langley. She's like the female version of her, him. She just gives you a really nice feeling through her body. She's really supple and she really wants to do it, which, yeah, just gives me a really good feeling and really excited about her.
It just, when you push that right button,
yeah,
and that trot suddenly gets bigger, it,
yeah,
just must be incredible.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
you probably feel what's to come with her as well.
Yeah, I think she's a real athlete and she just keeps getting better and better as she gets stronger. Yeah, exciting.
And the prospect of riding at Verdon, I mean, it's one of those things that I think a lot of people dream about, and sort of on that big world stage with so many amazing young horses.
Yeah, yeah. No, it'd be really exciting to get there. I rode Dior there when he was 5. This time it would be different, obviously, with it being indoors. It'd be a slightly different atmosphere. But it's a really exciting show to go to and see all the other amazing horses that are there.
And you mentioned Dior, our little favourite ginger pocket rocket.
Yeah.
How is he? Is he sort of,
yeah,
it's obviously a quiet season for him. But...
Yeah, quiet season, but we're aiming now for this Grand Prix Championships at Hartbury at the end of the 21st of December. And then plan next year, really.
It's hard to plan.
Yeah.
And obviously he's pretty solid at Grand Prix now, but
yeah,
I suppose it's just about taking that to the next step and maybe pressing for a place on a team,
yeah,
or something like that.
I think just aiming to get sort of over 70. Like, I know he can, and I make silly mistakes here and there, so I just want to start really getting it more polished and getting the scores that I know we can do. So.
And then any other the sort of younger horses coming up that you're excited about for next year?
St. Julian, he's really sort of stepping up to the Grand Prix work now, so we're hoping to start with him at Grand Prix next year, which is really exciting. And then I have Sakira and a horse called Toronto. They're both 7 and they're both doing small tour level, showing lots of promise. So, yeah,
super. Well, much to look forward to in 2021, hopefully, if
yes,
we can get rid of this horrible coronavirus,
yeah,
and get some vaccines going. Well, thank you for your time today, Tom. And we wish you the best of luck at Hartbury in December. And I'm sure everybody will be rooting for you with those fingers crossed and be watching on Horse and Country.
Thank you.